episode 61.
Oh my god, it's time.
Holy fucking shit.
Swastika City, dude.
Yeah. Take it back, dude.
I gotta take back my Call of Duty hatred. There were many swastikas.
There was ample swastikas. You felt comfortable?
There was a sufficient amount of swastikas, and so far I've only seen white guy soldiers.
Really?
Which is perfectly appropriate.
You've been scanning the ranks?
I've been looking at every soldier. I check his fucking
dog
tags.
It's like Mulan. You have a disguised woman amongst the ranks. Dude, maybe. You got to find her.
There might be some broads in there. I'm going to fuck them up. No, I think you run into those characters in the multiplayer. Like, I think you can design your own fucking guy.
Oh, so that's why.
If you were a black woman playing, you could make your character a black woman.
Okay, that makes sense.
That makes perfect sense.
But there was definitely people on the multiplayer being like, what the fuck?
But even then, I'd still be like, get out of here with that.
Well, you took it back, dude.
Say, shouldn't you be playing 2K?
Wow. Woo! Wow, dude.
Let's go, dude.
New year, new you. Year, new me. What's your resolutions?
Keep being racist? No, my New Year's resolution is to not say FAG, dude.
Really?
I'm going to not say it.
Nice.
Yeah. How about you?
What are you going to do each time if you do say it?
I'm going to go back to saying it.
This?
First time I say it.
My New Year's resolution is to learn how to dance and not be a wallflower.
Really?
Yeah.
That's gay. You shouldn't do that.
I'm such a wallflower, dude.
It's causing
a rift.
It's called being a man, dude.
No, dude. Well, yeah, you would think so, but I went to a Friday night.
All you have to do is lean back.
Dude, I tried to just post up on
just
the wall.
Just do the Rockaway.
Well, I'll go out with, like, Brittany has different groups of friends, and there's some of them that just, you know, I see and I don't really talk to. So I, like, will, like, say hi to, like, I'll be in a bar that's so loud I can't talk to anyone. So I'm like, I'll just stand by myself and chill. And apparently it, like, causes alarm. They're like, is he okay?
If you don't drink, which you don't really.
Yeah, it freaks people out.
If you're just fucking, yeah, I can see that.
It freaks people out. And it's like, dude, I don't want to drink.
Yeah.
So now I have to pretty much just get a drink and nurse it just to be cool.
Yeah.
And then just bust a move and not be a wallflower, dude.
You got to bust some moves.
I know.
Well, if you're not drinking, there's no chance I wouldn't. I'd dance.
I can't, dude. I can't move my body. If I don't have alcohol in my body.
If you're sober, trying to fucking dance.
Dude, I was in like a salsa club in Kensington somehow. I don't know how the fuck we ended up in this place.
Yeah.
But this place was actually pretty sick. But they had, the DJ, dude, was so fucking funny, dude. It was just a guy in the back. I didn't know Puerto Ricans listened to 80s music.
Really?
I walked into like a Puerto Rican bar and it was all 80s music.
Well, they love Scarface.
Yeah, I guess so.
They love that Miami
But place. It was like 80s music beats, but Spanish. And then people all knew the words who were younger. So I'm like, Puerto Ricans just record 80s music now?
Maybe.
It was really bizarre, dude. I've never seen anything like it.
What do you think the Puerto Ricans are up to, dude?
Recording 80s techno, dude, apparently. And I'm in there. I'm supposed to dance to Puerto Rican like 80s techno. And I'm not drinking. I'm in front of all these people I don't know. And then I just couldn't do it, dude.
You couldn't figure it out.
I couldn't get it. As soon as I'm not drinking and I move my body in a dancing way, in my head it's just like, you're fucking gay, dude. You're fucking white. You shouldn't do this. I instantly get like, I have like an SJW in my head who's like, you really shouldn't be doing this.
Yeah, dancing sucks.
I like it. If I get drunk, it's a fun thing.
If I get drunk,
world.
It's fun to just dick around. But, like, there was some dancing after the comedy show I did at McGoobies.
Yeah.
And it's weird. It's always weird when there's just a few black guys. And then all the white people like are like, oh, my God, look how cool these moves are.
Dude,
like, just
imagine
watching a black guy
put
dance.
Yourself in my scenario. I mean, New Year's Eve, I told you I was in VIP. So I've been in multiple. I have this weird fear of having to dance when I'm the only white guy around.
Oh yeah, you're getting judged.
That's what I said, but apparently,
definitely,
I know. And then I seize up, and I I get judged again, and it's like,
sure.
On New Year's Eve, I was definitely rocking. I mean, I drank like half a bottle of Crown Royal and fucking smoked my vape pen. So I was just like, then Brittany will stop me and try to show me how to dance. And I was just like,
oh,
stop.
Oh, that's so embarrassing.
Dude, every time
when
I dance in front of black people, I get instant like step up to the streets mode to where like I have to do really well. And I'm like, I got to fucking do this.
Oh my God, dude. Stop dancing. Just stop dance.
That's what I said. I try not to, dude.
You don't need to.
But the thing is like, so my bae's a really good dancer. So then she'll start dancing. Dudes will start meandering over towards her. So I got to start like bodyguarding and being like I had a guy. We were at one place on Friday when we met up with her cousins. And this guy was like, yo, you better claim your girl, dog. Some like fat Puerto Rican dude. And I was like, who the fuck are you? And he was like, oh, I'm almost playing, bro. I'm playing. He kept trying to shake my hand. I was like, dude, get away from me, man.
There's Puerto Ricans, dude.
They're after me
they're
all weekend.
Sharks.
He had, like, these soft, fat hands, and he's like, nah, I'm playing, bro. And he kept, like, handshaking me. I was like, dude, get your fucking squishy hands off me. I don't know you. I don't want to talk to you.
It's fucking Big Pun. He was coming for you. Yeah, you know Big Pun used to be skinny?
Nah.
Yeah, there's pictures of him online. He was, like, a male model. He was, like, fucking hot.
Dude,
And then when he died, I think he was like 700 pounds.
Is there a documentary on how fat he got?
Did you see?
That's almost admirable. Pounds. That's admirable, dude, to get yeah, that I don't know fat.
What the fuck he was doing.
Holy fuck. Dude, I really think about that sometimes, just being like, I should just get fat as fuck. Just get as fat. Just I just want to take up as much space as possible.
You want to take up space?
I just want to.
It's
just,
like an alpha.
I just want to fill the world, dude.
Yeah, skinny, big pun.
He was a male model. He was like hot.
Yeah, he was a fucking hot Puerto Rican dude.
Do you think he was Joe, the singer? No, Joe is black.
I mean, this is he's a little chubby in this, but
wow. Yeah, he's all GQ'd out.
Look at fucking Big Pun, dude.
When did you come across this?
I forget where I heard it.
Did you think he had a thyroid condition?
Because somebody was like, how much do you think Big Pun weighed when he died?
He was 700 pounds.
It was like 700 pounds.
Dude, imagine that, getting fucking craned out of your house. That's the end of the line for getting that fat. They got to take your wall out and lift you out of your house in a crane. They should just bury you right there.
28 years old, Big Pun died of heart failure, weighing nearly 700 pounds.
Dude, that is fucking awesome.
700, dude.
Holy
fuck. If you're 300, you're fat as fuck.
Yeah, you're a fucking
ball. If you're 400, you're
But dude,
insane.
Think about how sick that is.
Imagine being 300 pounds and then gaining 400 pounds.
Well, once you're 300, it's one of those like, you know, whatever that is, like a rolling snowball.
I guess.
It's just the bigger you are, the more mass you accumulate.
I guess, dude.
God, that's got to be fucking...
Being 700 pounds...
I would like to be that fat for like a week.
You might not make it.
I might die.
That would hurt. It would hurt to do anything.
Yeah, it would be tough to walk. Like, I mean, your heart at all times is like ready for a heart attack.
Ugh. Yeah, I was just reading an article about...
Probably strong as fuck, though.
If he would have lost weight, he would have been a fucking horse. He would have been a fucking Clydesdale underneath. He would have
been a bag of skin, dude.
Puerto Rican horse, dude. There's a comic named Chris Cope. He's a fat fucker.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
And he had a fucking aneurysm in his chest.
What?
At the Harrisburg Comedy Zone.
On stage?
Yeah, he was like 400 pounds. And his... No, after the show. And I guess what it was like... a tear in his heart or something. Oh. And he was internally bleeding to death.
Jesus Christ. Just from being fat.
Just from fattening up, his heart just ripped.
Like it was just his heart was torn. His heart was his heart was torn between tit weight. It was
really
just like pulling on your arms and legs, and finally it was like
how crazy is that?
That's horrible.
His heart ripped open. He was just like, oh man, my chest hurts. I gotta call somebody.
I mean, dude, I think about that a lot. Like when you hit 600 pounds, it's like, is that like depression or like what?
I was 320.
That's a big boy.
That was a big dog. That was a combination. That was depression and quitting football.
That's a quick road to getting fat.
Like 296 when I was playing.
Holy
which is
fuck.
Big. I should have been in like 280, 285. Still. I should have been like 290.
320 is a big dog.
320 was, that was a case of natural light every day. It was a case of natural light every day and fucking McDonald's. I'd just eat McDoubles.
You were just doing Supersize Me, the
double
documentary.
Heezies, dude. I was eating double Heezies. That's what I'm calling, dude. Fucking double Heezies. I'd get like three at a time. Three or four.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I just had a kid that would bring me a case of natural light and double cheeseburgers.
Who was his boy?
He loved the football team.
And he would come fucking.
Still my dog, dude.
He just would come feed you. You had a feeder.
I didn't even go to class. I stopped going to class.
Do you know what feeders and gainers are?
I had a feeder, yeah. Some guy that was just...
It's a sexual fetish.
Oh, he was getting horny?
Yeah, he was getting horny for you.
We talked about this. Yeah,
feeders and gainers.
He was getting fucking horny off this.
He's a feeder.
One time I...
You had a feeder, dude.
I would get fucking hammered, and he would do weird shit around me.
Of course.
Like, because I would black out.
He was a fat admirer.
I would black out all the time, and he would like... I just remember, because you know how, I don't know if you blacked out before.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you vaguely remember conversations.
Yeah.
Like, be like, did we fucking talk about this? Or like, something like
that. You
just
remember this guy's breath against your face?
I just remember him doing, like, or saying weird shit. And then one time I went to take a piss on the back porch, and then I walked back in, and he was sucking a bottle like he was sucking a dick. And I was like, what the fuck are you doing, buddy?
What the fuck?
And he's like, I was just deep-throating this bottle. And I was like, whoa, dude, that's fucking crazy.
What the fuck?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He was probably putting you on, like, under a chemical bondage, dude. He would probably fill you up with natty. He was probably giving you natty light injections.
That
dude,
was
and his huffing your limp bird.
The first semester of my sophomore year, and then I went home for Christmas.
You ditched him
Christmas break, and then just never came back.
So you had like a Stevie Janowski setup.
I had a Stevie.
He would just bring you fast food and beer,
dude. It was crazy,
dude. He definitely sucked your dick at one point.
Maybe
he definitely sucked your flask bird a couple times.
I was he got an unconscious, unresponsive bird.
He probably rang in the New Year one time on your
you
bird.
He rang
dude.
One
he probably
on
rang
me.
Down the counter. That's so funny. You were in a fetish relationship. Damn, dude.
I was in a fetish for McDonald's and Natural Light.
Yeah, I mean, I'm
Skull.
You had an admirer. You had an admirer.
Man, I still love Natural Light.
Do you really?
I love Natural Light,
dude. That's so fucking.
But
funny.
I would literally sit there and drink a case a day. Or like a case every 2 days.
You were in a fucking gingerbread house.
I was crushing.
That guy was fatting you up for the taking.
I just drank a case and played Xbox. Didn't go to class anymore.
That's tough, man.
Then I got home and mommy and daddy got my report card.
Was it bad?
I mean, I got fucking kicked out of school.
What was your GPA?
I don't even know. I didn't go to class.
Holy fuck.
I had like 5 incompletes.
Damn.
And they were just like, yeah, you can't come back.
Dude.
I was like, mom and dad, let me go back. And they were like, you're wasting our money, you fucking idiot. And I quit football, so there was no scholarship.
Yeah.
And Elon's expensive as fuck.
Yeah.
So they're like, you're a fucking loser.
Yeah, that sucks.
You're staying here. Oh, and I was like, damn.
That's a dark chapter.
I still had shit in my apartment. I didn't know I wasn't coming back.
Yeah, it's like
so
a really...
I had stuff in my house in North Carolina.
You had a fat intervention.
Pretty much. They're like, you're 320, dude. Knock it the fuck off.
If I have a kid and they hit like 250, I'm going to crane them out the window. I'm like, you're fat, dude. I'm craning you. Just crane them to the bottom, like walk up the steps.
Yeah, so I mean, because you could eat like that and drink like that if you were playing football.
Yeah, that's true.
Because then I was working out for 8 hours.
Yeah.
Every day.
No, that's true.
But then all of a sudden when you don't have to go to the gym and you're still munching those easies.
And the weight comes back
I was fat as fuck.
Dude, that's so funny.
And then, went home. Got on the mommy and daddy diet.
Just some boiled rice and some chicken.
They're like, dude, you need to chill out. I mean, at that point, all I had to do was go from eating 2 dozen wings to just a dozen.
Yeah.
And I would lose weight.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's on those shows when those people are like 600 pounds and they like just don't eat bags of sugar, it's like they lose like 100 pounds.
Yeah. If you were 700, you would lose weight by sneezing.
Yeah.
Like it would be crazy.
I'm at an all time high right now.
That's because you beefed, dude.
193,
bro. You
bulked
up. You got mass.
That's huge, dude.
193 is the highest you've ever been?
Yeah.
You've never hit 200 in your life?
Mm-mm.
You need to hit 2.
I'm going for it.
You're going to be 200?
I'm going, yeah.
Damn.
I'm trying to hit 200.
That's a meaty bull.
I know.
You're going to be a meaty bull.
Trying to get a meaty butt, dude.
You're going to fuck someone up in the VIP lounge.
I might.
I might beat up a Puerto Rican.
That was all I was thinking about. I was like, dude, I want to start coming to VIP all the time now. So,
really?
So basically my New Year's Eve, I got invited by my girlfriend's, me and my girlfriend got invited by her cousin.
Yeah.
And these were like how Stella got her groove back, black dudes, just like full peacoats, ties, just super fucking smooth. Dude.
Yeah.
And it was just fucking bizarre because they got tricked into spending $600 on Crown Royal behind a rope.
Oh.
Just a bunch of Metal Gear Solid dudes walking around with earpieces that probably don't even work. It was like a bunch of like Suge Knight looking dudes looking around like at all times. On the swivel, and like guys would move back and forth. It's so fucking weird.
VIP lounge sucks.
It's horrible. And every time I'm in one, I'm like, I'd rather fucking go down and just sit on the dance floor.
Sure.
If I'm gonna be in somewhere like that, but
yeah.
I was lording though. I started lording. There was definitely girls looking up, dude.
You were lord of the Puerto Ricans.
I was chilling in the back, dude. I was the only white guy.
Yeah, they probably thought you were like Post Malone.
Yeah, I had my sick long hair going, dude. They're probably like, damn, this guy. They probably thought I owned a record label. I was vaping in VIP. They're like, this guy's fucking sick.
If you're
sick.
The lone white guy around black dudes in a VIP lounge. You look like a fucking.
They probably thought I had a knife.
You're either an agent.
Yeah.
Or a fucking Post Malone.
Definitely. Probably thought I was a white rapper.
Definitely.
But yeah, I was chilling.
You could probably spit some bars.
I don't know if I could.
No, I think you absolutely could.
If I can't dance,
you'd
I don't
be
think I could
so
rap.
Bad.
Yeah, it'd be hard. For white rappers, the choice is like, do you do black voice or not?
It's tough.
It's tough. But if you don't do black voice, it kind of sucks.
Sure.
I have a weird thing about white rappers, dude.
You don't like them.
I don't really like them. I don't like white rappers. And I don't like white reggae artists.
I love Action Bronson. I like
Post
Malone.
He's good.
Post
Malone's good. Action Bronson's good.
I used to love Eminem till this last album.
He's tough. I loved Eminem at the appropriate time. When I was a young man, I was like, oh, he's the best.
No, Eminem's still the man.
I don't know that he is. I don't know.
He is, dude. Now that last album, I don't like him.
I felt bad for him, really. I listened to that. I listened to a little bit of it. I'm like, man, this guy's having a tough time, and he shouldn't be.
Yeah.
If you're that rich and famous, just fucking hang it up, man.
He's always had a tough time.
That's true.
He's always been addicted to fucking drugs. And
yeah.
So, like, there was a while where his music was so fucking bad.
Yeah.
When he was, like album Relapse and shit. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
Yeah, that was tough. Well, he used to eat a lot of shrooms.
And he would have, like, funny songs.
Yeah.
Where he would use a weird twangy voice.
He went through
like,
some.
Oops, my CD just skipped, and everybody heard you let one rip. Like that was a bow, 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 bow.
Well, he's doing like 45-year-old dude jokes.
Yes.
But yeah, I know in his early days, apparently he used to eat mushrooms. A lot of rappers eat mushrooms on the sly.
He's addicted to pills. Yeah. And mushrooms, I'm sure.
Yeah.
He had a song about mushrooms.
Yeah.
He had a couple. Yeah.
He might be a full-blown mushroom addict.
That was the problem. I think it was probably like Oxycontin.
Yeah, no. I don't think that happens. I don't know if there is a full-blown. I think that just takes care of itself.
What, being addicted to shrooms?
It's just impossible. I think you just end up like in the woods somewhere. And then like you come back a month later and everyone's like, what the fuck's going on with you? I had a guy the last time. What the fuck? Oh, so I went to Firefly. Like years ago.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that was weird. That was when I realized I was old.
My
was
girlfriend tried to get me to go to Firefly.
Dude, don't do it.
And she doesn't do drugs or really get fucked up.
Yeah.
Like, so why the fuck are we going to this?
It's mostly for chicks to like pretend they're a hippie for like 2 days.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's weird because usually they're at least like smoking weed or doing Molly. But I went down there with a bunch of guys and they ate mushrooms. And the one guy like ended up freaking out. And he... I remember, like, I came back looking for him, and he was just cleaning up. He was walking around the lot and cleaning up litter. And then, like, 2 days later, he sent me a Facebook message asking me if I had any history textbooks. He was trying to read up on history.
What?
And this got fucking weird, dude.
Two days later, he was still fucked up?
If you eat, I mean, it'll throw you off. Like, it'll give you a weird idea. I mean, dude, look at me now. I ate mushrooms on the beach a year ago. I haven't cut my hair since. So it definitely will throw in some weird ideas in there.
Dude, it's been a year since you cut. It's been over a year.
It's been like a year and 6 months.
Damn.
I just can't cut it, dude.
Why?
I don't know. I can't cut it.
I'm going to cut it.
No, dude. It's coming in good right now.
It looks nice.
I want to hit 200 and have hair down in my butt. I'm going to get real weird. I'm going to start getting into like medieval weapons training. Just get fucking jacked. That's my New Year's resolution.
You're going to get jacked
this
as
has fuck? Become like a Ren Faire challenge.
I was just saying, you just want to turn into a Ren Faire person?
My life has been either like, it's just a slow roll into me being like a Ren Faire actor or just being like a jet ski tour guide. It's like one or the other.
Those are sick fucking gigs.
I know.
Those are sick gigs.
I know.
Ren Faire guy is going to suck.
I'd be nasty at it. Well, I'd be in the Ren Faire circuit for like a year before getting scooped up into Game of Thrones.
You think?
That's what the whole point of it is.
Ren Faire is like the minor leagues for Thrones?
Yeah, so it's a minor league Thrones. It's minor league Thrones and minor league 300.
Sick.
Yeah.
There's a girl that does open mics in Lancaster.
Yeah.
And Lancaster has a big Ren Faire.
Really?
Yeah.
That's a good scene
like
there?
That's a big scene for the Ren Faire.
Damn.
It's like the Pennsylvania Renaissance Fair. It's Lancaster.
In Lancaster.
Yeah. And this girl does it, and they gave her like a flute and a bunch of rats that follow her around. Like her gig at the Ren Faire is to
so funny.
Be like a
Pied Piper.
Pied Piper for the rats.
What kind of rats are we talking?
I don't know.
They let some live ones out?
They tie them to her, so when she walks around, they follow her.
Ugh. I don't know if I'm about the Ren Faire.
I mean, she's a little retarded.
Yeah, I mean.
She's a little fucking... I made fun of her for it. I felt bad.
To her face?
Yeah. She was at an open mic.
With rats attached
to
her?
How shitty you have to be to like show up to the Ren Faire and be like, I'd like to be a princess. And they're like, no, you're the rat lady.
You're the rat lady.
You fucking are the rat lady. Go.
Ugh.
Get out of here.
That sucks.
Yeah.
Poor lady.
I've never been to a Ren Faire.
Me either. I'm waiting. I'm just going to break in cold.
I think that would piss me off.
A Ren Faire?
Yeah.
All I know about Ren Faire is that you eat big turkey legs.
Yeah, I mean, that would be sick.
Yeah.
But then they're like, here's some mead. It's like, dude, this is Miller Lite. Like, stop.
This is Miller Lite with honey in it.
Yeah. It's a bunch of comic book fans and shit. Nah, yo.
Yeah. I always think I've LARPing something I've secretly been like, man, I'd enjoy that.
LARPing looks sick.
Man, I'd enjoy that.
Yeah.
I LARPed before.
You LARPed?
It was a sketch. someone was doing a sketch and there was like LARPing was involved, but the one guy was like a heavy LARP head. And he, I was like, I'm gonna fuck this nerd up in LARPing. Dude, he fucking destroyed me.
He crushed you in LARPing.
Well, he went, he's like, what weapons do you want? And I was like, double sword, Spartacus style. And he was like, you need a shield. And I was like, I don't need a fucking shield, dude. You fucking nerds are gonna hurt me. Dude, those fucking weapons hurt.
Yeah, what are they, pool noodles?
It's like pool noodle around like a wiffle ball bat. So you get hit hard enough and it's just like, ow, what the fuck? So I went in with double swords and just got fucked up by nerds, dude. I got my ass beat.
I saw there were kids that LARPed by my house in Westchester.
Really?
Yeah. There's like a park by campus that they would LARP at.
Hey, you should have went out there.
I would just beep the horn, call them fucking gay.
Did you really?
Yeah.
That's so funny.
They would do it like every Sunday.
I mean, they must have got called gay like 15 times.
The whole time they were out there, must have been getting called gay by college kids. But it looks fun.
It's so, dude, it really is fun.
Yeah. Sick. Sick yeah. Cast.
Sick 61, cast. Dude. LARPing, dude.
LARP City. Yeah, that's all I want to say.
I came
yeah.
in what?
I gotta brag, dude. I gotta get,
brag
out,
it up, dude.
Shout out to Dan Soder, dude.
Oh yeah, yeah.
That was a big. He made a big prediction.
Mm.
So they interviewed a bunch of comedians who they thought was gonna be the next big thing in 2018.
Shit.
He said the Shane Gillis.
What website was this?
It's called the Interrobang.com.
Yeah, that's sick. That's a big site. That's yeah. I know Interrobang, Splitsider are like two.
It was a terrible pick though.
What pick to hit you with the old school big. Face shot?
Oh, my God. Yeah. So there's like a collage picture of yeah. like all these really good comedians and then me. And
that's
my
sick.
Picture is that old headshot.
It's like a pixelated.
So fucking
oh,
corny.
I know a headshot.
The headshot that just I can't escape.
That's so funny.
I look as white as snow, which I am, but like pure white with like slicked parted hair.
That's sick, dude.
And like a senior portrait photo, like turned to the side.
It's an obituary.
I like turn to the side and like, oh my God. Turn to the side, like looking over my shoulder.
That
like
was the one on the
hair.
Billboard in down
yeah,
south.
Yeah.
That's a classic. That's a classic.
I don't even know
photo.
Where these people are getting this photo.
They just go and they rip them off of Facebook and stuff. They just go and take them.
That show I did Thursday or Friday night used a bio from like right when I started. Like my first bio.
Oh, did they really?
Yeah. It was like he's an up and comer out yeah. of central PA.
That's sick.
He's performed at clubs like Stitches in Lancaster. He's opened for
Dustin Diamond, dude.
I did have Carlos Mencia on there.
Nice. That's a, dude, that you should keep that.
I should keep Dustin Diamond, Carlos Mencia. So it should say Screech, Carlos Mencia, and Chris Kattan.
That'd be awesome.
Those are my three openers. It'd be like, has performed at a bowling alley in Reading.
Dude, that'd be awesome.
Stitches, Lancaster.
That'd be fucking sick.
That would be a sick bio.
I hate writing those things.
Bios are the corniest shit on earth. Headshots are fucking gay.
Yeah, bios headshots are maybe gay. The worst.
If you take a serious headshot, you fucking suck.
Yeah, that. And I see and a lot of I see a lot do. Of comedians, a lot of girl comedians take like super sexy
girl
photos.
Girl comedians love that.
They love taking like super photo shoots and it's like, what the fuck does this have to do with stand-up?
They yeah, there's always just every single female comic I think I know.
Yeah.
Has like an album on Facebook of
just hot chicken.
Just headshot of
well, that's
being
a,
hot.
That's a weird girl urge is like being hot and being perceived as hot.
Yeah.
Because like when like especially like nurses and people who wear uniforms and like it's time to like meet up with their coworkers, they get like super dressed to the nines.
Yeah.
It kills a girl, dude. It's like as jacked as I am to wear like if I had to wear like loose bicep shirts all the time. If that was my uniform, I'd definitely throw on like a snug Ed Hardy.
You need to get a snug shirt. You got jacked. Are you jacked right now?
Yeah, I'm fucking jacked.
That's sick. Get to 200.
You know Tom Hardy's name's really Ed Hardy?
What?
Yeah, Tom Hardy's real name is Edward Thomas Hardy. His name's Ed Hardy.
Damn.
And he changed it. He's probably like, those t-shirts probably came out. And he was like, motherfucker. I can't be Ed Hardy the actor.
Every piece of information I get about Ed Hardy just contradicts everything I know about him.
Tom Hardy. Yeah.
Tom, like, he's one of my favorite actors. Not that him being gay would have anything to do with it, but just
is
like
it,
when you
he
see
gay?
Him, he used to fuck some guys.
Yeah,
he's bi.
Okay,
but it's still like you see him acting, and it's like, damn, that guy's the. Alpha.
I feel like if you're that good at acting, you have to fuck some guys. There's no
yeah,
way.
He fucks some guys. His real name's Ed Hardy.
Yeah.
He's like,
yeah, that's true.
His real life is he's a bisexual dude named Ed Hardy.
Yeah. That's his real life.
And then on screen, he's the fucking...
Brilliant actor.
Great actor.
He was just in... he's in Peaky Blinders.
Yeah.
He plays the old Jew.
Yeah. He was in Peaky Blinders in season 2 also.
Yep.
Made a comeback in 4. He's the best.
Dude, I came back on New Year's Eve, and I was so fucking drunk and stoned. And I started watching those vampire soap operas with Brittany before
I went
to bed.
Why are you watching those?
I mean, that's just what we watch. So I was watching the show, and I was like, in my head, just like, vampire soap operas are the best. I fucking love these. And woke up the next morning, and I had no fucking idea what I'd watched. She's like, you want to finish the episode? And I was like, we watched an episode. And I remembered being like, God, these are just the best.
Oh, you were telling me about Black Mirror. I just watched Black Mirror.
Yeah, dude. It's weird. I mean, I don't want to spoil episode 3. You said you started, but there's a part of that that I almost was like, get the fuck out of here.
They hit
dude.
You with the progressive.
Not, dude. Okay, so you saw that girl. This won't spoil that much. You saw that girl, right?
Yeah.
You know the dude who fucking hit the dude on the bike?
Yeah.
Do you think she could overpower him and
absolutely
like murder him with her bare
hands?
Zero
chance.
Yeah, that's like. She like overpowers him and chokes him out.
I don't know if there's
she's like 110 pounds.
I don't know if there's anything that bothered me more growing up or well now is when a girl thinks she can beat you up.
Yeah.
Like I remember there were these three girls in high school and for some reason we were talking about if I could beat up all three of them.
Yeah.
And they were like, we would beat the shit out of you.
What?
And it was like three hot chicks and I was lifting every single day. Like I was pretty fucking huge.
Yeah.
Like I just said, I was like,
there's no way.
I was like 300 fucking pounds. And there were three hot chicks. They're like, we would just jump on your back and scratch you. I'd be like, I would fucking beat you to death.
I would allow them to beat me up for a while.
Yeah. I mean,
just for my own sexual perversion. And then I would fucking murder them.
Break out of it. And fucking suplex.
Be so, dude, if it wouldn't even, you wouldn't even beat them up. You'd give one of them a 40% punch to the head and then the rest of them would scatter.
Yeah,
there's no way three hot chicks is watching someone get their eye socket caved in and like going in number two, like, I got you.
Or like when girls, whenever I hear a woman like guess who would win in a fight.
Between
it
who?
It just pisses me. Like anybody.
Yeah,
like you could ask a girl like who would win a fight, me or Justin Timberlake. And they'd be like, Justin.
Yeah.
It's like, why? It's like, look how athletic he is. He dances. You can't even move. It's like, I would fucking destroy him.
Yeah, you absolutely would.
But in a girl's mind, it's just like whoever's hot, like David Beckham would
whoever's
beat
rich
the shit
and hot.
Out of anybody.
Yeah, of course.
It's like,
he'd
no,
just
he
kick
wouldn't.
You.
I mean, David Beckham might fuck me up.
I don't think so.
He's a real athlete.
No way. No way David Beckham can match. Unless he has like American Psycho rage, there's no way he can match.
I don't know. Like when it comes to soccer players, that's the tough one. That's a tough one.
I
if
don't
they
know
can
about
fight.
Fist fighting. I don't think those guys fist fight all that much.
I don't
much.
Think they fist fight all that much, but still they're athletes. That
true.
Could, that I mean, if
true.
The,
but it's like one of
are competitive
as soon
fuck.
As a fist flies to their head, dude. It might. It all depends. Some people you never
know
that.
Like that's the Cristiano Ronaldo argument. It's like because that guy's a fucking horse.
He is. He's a mule,
and he's got to be a psycho.
Yes,
he's got to be competitive as fuck.
That's true.
So I don't know. They say the same thing about LeBron. Everybody's like, oh, he's a pussy.
Yeah,
it's like, dude,
he's
a
six,
monster.
He's a, what, a 6'8" fucking...
He's like 300 fucking pounds.
Yeah, he's not a pussy. I mean, he might not get in fist fights all the time, but...
I he's 300. He lost some weight. He's skinnier.
Still. He's, what, 6'8"?
He would literally kill you.
Yeah.
He would kill you.
Dude, it was funny.
And he's a pussy. He flops. It's like, yeah, on the court, he's also an animal.
Dude, yeah. That's not even... If people say they can beat up LeBron James, it's like, all right, Ben, you got it.
Yeah.
Just get the fuck out of my face.
Like, there's no one in the NFL I think I could beat up. There's probably, and even then, it's
I could.
Like
I think I could beat
kicker.
Up a punter. I think I could take a punter.
There's some punters out there that'll fuck you up.
I know, but I'm saying I think I could take a
think
couple.
You could find one.
Yeah, I think I could. I think I could take a couple down.
Yeah,
I actually would like to play football against. That would be a cool, like a pregame. Just do like regular dudes playing football against punters and kickers.
I don't know. They might fuck you up.
You think
there's
so?
Probably some.
Well, they're probably in pretty good condition.
Some punters you can smash.
Yeah, I think I could.
But, there's like I remember I was sitting there talking with my dad. We were watching the NBA, and I was asking him what players on the court he could beat up. He was drunk, and he was just
all
naming
them.
All these players. I was
really?
Like, Dad, they would fucking kill you, dude.
Yeah, but I feel like as an older white dude, you're so ready to die that like it throws in a factor to where it's like your dad's in his head, like, dude, I would just go out in a blaze of glory.
That's ISIS mentality.
I'd pull his
He's
eyes
like,
out.
I'll take on the United States military, dude.
Yeah, your dad's probably like
I don't give a
your
fuck.
Dad in his head. You're thinking about like fist fighting. He's probably thinking like pulling eyes out and fucking gouging and fish hooking.
Yeah, that's
I mean, that's the thing with Justin Timberlake. There's like no, it's hard to match a common man's like bleak rage versus like Justin Timberlake. Who's just if you're having like mad three and foursomes, And then you just like fight the average like Redditor fucking porn addict, dude. It's like there's no, that guy's gonna rip you apart. Dude, I was in the fucking throes of porn addiction this morning.
Really?
Last night and this morning. I woke up this morning. I felt like Tom Cruise from The Last Samurai. When he wakes up and he's like, "Sake!" I was just in my head screaming for porn, dude. And I was all feverish. I'm sick. So I woke up all feverish and confused, and I was just like, ugh, compilations.
You needed to see it.
I needed some compilations, and you didn't, dude. Do it? No, I didn't.
Damn.
I didn't impressive. Do it.
Now, dude, when it comes to a nofap, if you were to see porn, would you jerk off?
What do you mean?
Like if I hit you with some porn right now, what would happen to you?
It'd be hard, man.
Would you go home and jerk off?
I might have a masturbatory episode.
I remember the masturbatory episode you had when we were hanging
out. At your friend's house.
We heard a girl getting fucked, and you, dude, were like, I gotta go home.
It sent me right home. I was on 8 days hard mode, or seven, I think. And I heard that girl, and I'd like seen her all night.
I know.
And then just to hear her, to hear her soft fucking moans, dude. I instantly was like, I gotta go. Went home, and it's pure pure imagination bang fapped. Like a hard fucking shaking, like Diary of a Vampire's cum. Just like,
so nobody watches Diary of the Vampire, dude.
Well, you know,
don't
what I'm
use
about.
Those references.
I'm thinking of like a candlelit, just like white sheeted bed where I'm like, dude, you have to finish watching Black
Mirror. Using vampire references.
You have to watch the rest of Black Mirror. It's so funny.
Is that why you're growing your hair? You do look like a vampire now, dude.
Well, that'd be cool. I could get into if I could get into some vamp soaps, dude. That'd be awesome.
You look like a vamp. You got the goatee. You're pale.
Yeah, I gotta get a little hair. Less jacked.
You look medieval.
I look more like a werewolf, I'd say.
Oh, yeah, true.
I look more like a were, but...
You look like a hybrid.
Oh, dude, you know about hybrids?
A werewolf vamp?
How the fuck do you know about that?
I don't know. I came up with that just now.
That's probably how the writing for those shows works. Because there are
it's
hybrids.
Like, and they can fly, and they can move.
Well,
like this,
a vampire, fucking... vampires will die from a werewolf bite.
Really?
In 24
just
hours.
A bite?
Unless
just
given,
a bite?
Yep, unless given the blood of an immortal. Or the blood of a hybrid.
Wow.
So you got to watch out for that.
You got to watch out for were bites.
Yeah. Same vice versa. If a vamp bites a werewolf.
I was always a werewolf guy.
Really?
I was always a fan.
The werewolves are so fucking lame, dude. They're like...
I mean, now I'm sure everybody in that show is fucking lame, by the
yeah.
way.
Yeah. Well, the witches are pretty sick. But yeah.
There's
bitches? There's bitches, yeah.
What do the witches do?
They just fucking put curses and hexes on people, dude.
You love curses.
My favorite part of the vampire shows is how vampires always move so fast. Because they'll be like, someone will come in the house and like, whoosh, and
yeah,
right
yeah,
behind
yeah,
them.
Yeah, yeah.
But then they drive for some reason, too.
I watched True Blood.
Yeah, and they move real
and
fast.
They
fuck really quick.
And then like middle of an episode, I remember True Blood was like on the same time as Entourage.
Yeah.
Like the same night.
They were like, think about that. They were like the two best shows for a while.
And I would be watching, I just remember I was like middle of an episode of True Blood. And I was just like, oh, this is the dumbest fucking shit I've ever seen in my life. And I never watched it again.
Yeah, I watched a whole
first. I was like
mid
season. I was just like, wow.
See,
this
I watched
is so bad.
I watched that show, but more for like, there was so many sex scenes. And there was a couple girls I had my eye on in that show.
I liked that.
Sookie.
I liked that redhead, whew, dude.
Oh, you liked her?
So fucking hot.
I liked Sookie, and I liked the, whatever that black chick's name was.
She was just in
hot.
Something I watched. Oh, Sookie? She was in Punisher, the redhead.
Sookie?
The redhead.
Okay.
Sookie wasn't hot.
She had
Sookie
something
was
about
not
it.
As hot as the
she had,
redhead.
I know, but she had something
that
about
redhead
her.
Redhead vamp?
She was pretty hot.
What?
I wasn't that into her.
Woo!
All my cousins and shit are redheads, dude. That's like,
yeah.
I got negative imprinted on that. If I see a redhead, it's just kind of like, hey, nice to meet you.
Well, there's a lot of ugly redheads.
Yeah.
When you run into a hot redhead, it's...
But a hot redhead is like super pale and fair-skinned, you know what I mean?
I'm all right with that.
Not this kid, dude.
This is my dwelling.
Not this kid.
I live in the shadows.
You live in the shadows. I'm pale.
I'm a fat vamp, dude. I move slow. Like, when they're all flying, I'm like...
You're like... Yeah, you just move like 4 feet. Dude... But yeah, Black Mirror this season it's like the same thing you're saying with Star Wars. It's like, for the most part, not every single episode, but it's usually like a bad white. It's all female leads, and this is something they came up with. They're like, it's all going to be female leads.
Yeah.
And but yeah, that one girl is like 110 pounds. She like overpowers and chokes a dude to death.
Oh my god!
And that was just like, and then she goes on a spree from there, and it's kind of like, huh?
Yeah.
So that was weird. But they had a couple ones that were really... They had one where this guy has, like, his girlfriend is in a coma. So he gets her consciousness and plant it in his head. So his girlfriend's in his head at all times. He's everything God. I know, dude. I was watching this and I was like, good fucking God.
I had to left the house the other day, or last night, to watch the Sugar Bowl. I had to leave the house because my bitch was yapping.
She sees through his eyes. She was seeing through his eyes.
Don't give it away.
Oh, dude,
don't
it's
give it away.
Fucking horrifying.
I gotta watch the rest of this.
Horrifying.
If your fucking broad was in your head.
Yeah, but his broad, it was a white chick. And then, you know, he put her out.
stop. Sorry. I'm going to watch these.
I'm going to stop spoiling it. But, dude, there was a definite theme where, like, it was just bad, with the exception of one, but it was mostly just, bad white people.
White guys are creating the dystopian future we're about to enter.
I know.
And it's only up to white women to save us.
And that was the thing.
And women of color, which is...
Yeah, but
white women are the ultimate saviors. They've always been so good at... Anytime... You ever notice how, like, when there's a fight or a disaster, white women usually are the ones not screaming and ruining it?
Yeah, pretty much.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just screaming and acting irrational?
Yeah.
They never do that.
Never freak out.
They never constantly scream and freak out for no reason.
Nah, dude. They fucking grab your wrist, flip you over.
They say, come on, let's go.
They put you down.
Get out of here.
Choke you out, dude. Oh, dude. That was the one point. I'm watching it, like, trying to keep an open mind, get with the times, and I saw that, and I was just like, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah.
Please stop.
I watch.
I think they're trying to trigger dudes into being just like full neo-Nazi.
They're
just
walking on me. They got me like 10 different times this year. This is Star Wars. They got me Call of Duty rumors. They got me on a bunch. But
I went right from there to Whole Foods too. So I'm in Whole Foods. Like, fuck you guys. I saw a dude with like purple hair, and I was like, fuck you, dude.
Ugh.
You're fucking ruining Black Mirror for me somehow.
The
first season was like dudes fucking pigs. It was sick.
It was sick. That's what life is.
Yeah,
I need reality, dude. I need a guy fucking a pig.
The first one was the most telling, of like some white guy trapping a bunch of POCs in his sexual fantasies and not letting them out.
The first one was sick.
That was so funny. It's like, we need a tough fucking girl to turn this around. And then, did you notice at the very beginning when they were like, what can we do now? Like, they got rid of the evil white guy, and they're like, we have a whole universe. Let's go explore it now. And I was watching this. I'm like, this is fucking... They're turning the bays into communists, dude.
Yeah.
We can't let our bays become communists.
Bays are communists, dude.
You think so?
Yeah.
They're pretty concerned with...
It's a maternal...
What's fair.
Instinct to be like...
True.
Everyone gets it, you know?
Yeah. Got to make sure our bays...
Mothers are nice to the runt.
Got to make sure the bays don't become communists.
While the men destroy the runt.
True.
And say, we need big men and swastikas in our video games. And white stormtroopers.
I started listening to this book about just like human beings evolving, and they were going into how there was like Neanderthals. And there was like we had like a whole species of midgets too.
They were midgets.
Yeah, there was people. Yeah, they were 3 feet, and they just kind of chilled. And it's funny because they hunted elephants, but there was
Guyana.
Also midget elephants too.
Really?
So they hunted. There was midgets on an island hunting midget elephants, and at one point. Just normal dudes fucking rolled out normal sized, I should say, dudes.
Damn. Think about the broads kings, they got
king
out
sized
of that.
Dudes. It was funny to think 10,000 years ago for like a king sized dude to be like, huh? See like midgets and be like, I'm going to go fuck one of those midget girls and kill those guys. Like that's in their head, they're like, all right, we're going to fucking obviously kill these midget dudes and fuck these midget girls.
Yes.
It must have been so weird to be alive back then.
Dude.
When you just saw them and you're like, I'm going to fuck one of these midgets and kill these. It must have been so... Think about how fun that was.
To land on an island and see a bunch of midgets.
Oh, my
like,
God.
Oh, my God.
You're
game
in,
over.
Yeah, exactly. You're in business of just, like, completely pillaging and destroying villages, and the village you roll up on is full of, like, three-footers, and you're like... It's like when you're playing basketball on, like, a five-foot rim. You're like, dude, I'm going to dunk. I'm going to do... They're, like, 360 dunking. They're probably, like, kicking their heads off and shit.
I mean, that's... In a more recent example is Columbus coming to the
Americas
and just seeing... People that have nothing and just being like, game time.
Yeah.
This is mine now.
Game set match.
Give me some gold or I'm cutting your fucking ears off.
But they were still good with like, like bow hunting and like sick tracking skills.
Yeah,
I don't think these midges.
Pygmies.
Yeah, I don't think these midges. No, the Indians. I don't think the midges were like that sick at a lot of stuff.
You think they just sucked? They're just shitty.
I mean,
midgets.
Dude, you're a midget in the wild, dude. That's fucking.
Well, I bet they were proportional, though. They weren't like modern midgets with like shitty arms.
You think they used to like roll in a ball?
Yeah, midgets have like crocodile arms.
You think they had like jacked little muscle arms?
I bet they were like small humans.
Yeah, that's what midgets are. Oh, you don't think they were like kind of like...
Big-headed alligator arms.
Yeah, they probably were like jacked
baby
little warriors. They're like little Cabbage Patch kids, dude.
Yeah, they're probably small little guys. It's probably like a bunch of Okanis. Just jacked, handsome little
when
guys.
When they were saying the height, I'm like, all right, they're going to say, you know. I didn't expect it was going to be fucking 3 feet. It was like 3'6" average height. Just got their fucking...
I wonder what those babes were looking like.
Dicks
dude.
Kicked in. They're hot,
what do you
dude.
Think about a nice 3 foot babe?
Whew.
How would you like to have about six of them in your bed squirming around, huh?
You know what? I told you that before. That midget porn is something I tried to get into and was like, not for
midget
me.
Midget porn. Well, again, not for you're me. Thinking of them as midgets.
Yeah, I guess they're more of like the house cats of midgets, really.
Midgets tend to be kind of gross looking. Well, gross is the wrong thing, but deformed.
When they're hot, though, when they have a hot face, it is kind of confusing. It's like,
What did you say about house cats?
Today's midgets are like the house cats of midgets. Yeah, these are like the OG strain.
They were wildlife
midgets. Yeah, these are like the saber-toothed tiger midgets, dude. They're like
Oh my God.
But that was cracking me up, dude. Just imagine those dudes 10,000 years with no moral compass just to be like sick.
What was the word for them in Gulliver's Travels?
I have no idea. They tied the guy up.
Yeah. Midges. Those them, dude.
Midgies.
I wanted to say this. I've been watching fucked up videos.
What'd you watch?
Just fucking every time I watch a fucked up video, women just screaming.
Yeah.
It's like, shut the fuck up.
What, I mean, people are getting their heads chopped off and shit?
No, just like, I watched a crane collapse the other day. Yeah. And just a woman was just screaming at the top of her lungs while it was collapsing.
She didn't fucking go underneath? She didn't run up and catch it?
No, from a very long distance, she was just like,
Yeah, dude, it was total chaos.
I would look at her and just be like, shut the fuck up. That does nothing.
Yeah, that's not hurting you at all.
Just stop.
Yeah, they're just wired differently, dude.
Yeah, They're like seagulls. Why they just start cawing?
They're wired to choke you out, dude.
Yeah, I know.
You're gonna get fucking choked out.
Not me?
Yeah, some 150-pound, some girl's gonna come up 115 pounds, gonna fucking put you down, dude.
I mean, I'm sure there's a 110-pound lady out there that does martial arts that could choke me.
Yeah, but I don't know. I doubt it.
I could probably flex and bust out of that.
Yeah, I think you could at least bite her arm really hard.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I could beat the fuck out of most women.
Yeah, except for those Russians.
That's my resolution.
To beat the fuck out of most women?
My resolution.
Or just to let them know.
Most women this year.
That's a sick thing to do in a relationship. Just not hit your girlfriend or wife, but let her know. Like
she knows.
Just to vocalize it, be like, look, I would never hit you, but if I fucking did, I would bash your fucking
If you get
eye.
Me fired up, I might strangle you to death.
Just let them know. Be like, I could, literally.
Yeah.
Just, I could just pull your eyes out.
You think that's a good thing to say to your woman?
Yeah, let them know.
Just like on your first date.
It's like, I could literally jump on your head and kill you.
Yeah. It's the first date, just like, hey, this is going really well. I also want you to know I could pull your fucking teeth out if I felt like it. I could hold you down and rip your teeth out with pliers.
Or even just when you're walking, put your arm around her and just fucking give a good squeeze and make you feel that. That's
imagine that.
That's half of what I got. I could
tear off your ears.
I could literally crack your neck.
Yeah, that's good. I think that was I think my dad said that in his vows.
He said I could fuck you up.
He's like, I just want you to always remember. Rip your fucking nose out. I hold you by the under the nostrils and pull.
I haven't been to a good wedding in a while.
I was at a wedding on fucking Friday night.
How was that?
I got there late as fuck.
That's sick.
I did a show.
Wait, were you in like everyday regular gear?
I did a show in North Jersey.
Yeah.
I think the biggest crowd I've ever performed for.
Oh, yeah.
I forget
theater.
What the Fillmore was. What's the Fillmore?
I was about, I thought.
What's the Fillmore seat?
I'm going to say 2,500.
The Fillmore was probably.
Fillmore was probably
75% full when I was on.
Yeah.
Maybe full by the time.
I would
time.
Say it's about.
So that was probably the biggest. The Fillmore was the biggest. This was the second. This was 1,200 people.
Nice.
Packed. 1,200 seat theater. It was
How
sick.
Far were you from the people from the stage?
Pretty far.
Yeah. You had like the pit going on?
Yeah. And there's a big ass balcony. It was sick.
Yeah, this time.
That was a good show. I hosted and I fucked up the guy's name right away.
Who the
first guy? Melvin George.
Oh, it was like a whole. Yeah.
Melvin George the second. Some old black dude that did like.
What'd you call him?
Melvin George the third.
Oh, man, you were that close?
Yeah.
Did he bust like, your
second,
balls about
second,
the third?
Second. No, he didn't bust my balls. He was his act was. He's been doing the same thing since 1980. He did not change a word, dude.
Really?
He was just full on fucking like, hello, welcome. And they did a.
Remember we did Levity Live? There was all those old black nerds. God. They were pretty brutal.
This guy was like really good, but a while ago. Like
yeah.
He had done like Letterman
yeah.
and all, or like all the old shit. And then now it was like, It's kind of sad.
Yeah.
To just have an act from the 80s that you just never changed.
Yeah, why wouldn't you do that?
I know. I don't get it.
Then again, it's also pretty sick to bring that fucking into the future. Like, the fuck it. Yeah, I'm just going to do this till I die.
Yeah. And then the next guy, who's good? He was good.
Yeah.
Moody McCarthy, he was good.
Sick name.
Yeah. White Bull, he did Letterman. He did Kimmel.
Nice.
He was cool. And then I brought out the legend, dude.
Hell was the fucking Rich Voss, man.
Fucking hilarious. Crushed it. He did like an hour and 10 minutes, too.
Ooh.
Supposed to do 50. He was having fun, man.
Really?
So then I left there, and I hosted, so I had to stay the whole fucking time.
That sucks.
Which really sucked. So I drove from North Jersey down to Westchester. I got pulled over right away. I got pulled over by a cop, which was funny, because I had those weed gummies in the car. And when I got out to my car stunk like weed.
Really?
Yeah. Smelled like weed. It was cold. I don't know. Maybe that.
I thought they were sealed up.
They were in a Ziploc bag.
Huh.
And in my center console.
Oh, they weren't like sealed with like. Mm-mm. Oh, wow.
And then I got in my car and I was like, fuck, it stinks like weed, but whatever. Just don't get pulled over.
Yeah.
First exit. Right when I got onto the highway, I got pulled over. And like as the sirens came on, I was like, oh my God. I have fucking weed in here.
Weed gummies, dude.
So I put the windows down like while I was pulling over. Yeah. It was fine. Guy let me go with a warning.
Really?
It's going 83 and 65.
Woo.
He was like, next cop might not be so nice. I was like, dude, you're the best.
Fuck yeah.
It's like, you're the man. I was
he
like,
probably hey. Listens to the cast.
I told him I was doing stand-up.
What did he say?
He was like, where are you coming from? I was like, I was at the Mayo Performing Arts Center doing that. He was like, oh, how'd you do? He's like, you fucking crushed? He said kill. He was like, did you kill it? I was like, yeah. Like, I was just like, yeah, it was the best thing of my life, dude. Thanks. Oh,
that's so funny.
And then I drove to my friend's wedding that I had skipped for that show. And the reception ended at 1 a.m. And I got there at like 12:50. So I just drove to the reception, walked in. Everybody was hammered, singing the Eagles fight song.
So you were plainclothes?
I was in jeans and a t-shirt.
Nice.
And I walked in. And then we went back to the hotel and I drank till like 5.
God damn.
Yeah, it was rough.
Then Rockstar lifestyle.
So then I went from a show that was a theater with like 1,200 people. Mm-hmm. Then the next night I was at like a vineyard in Hershey, PA for like 8 people.
Really?
Yeah.
How were they?
It was weird. It was fucking shitty. That was really shitty. And then McGoobs.
The ultimate,
dude.
McGoobers. That's fucking sick. That's so funny that guy left the stage and had to come back on.
Oh my God. Yeah. What do you think, dude? What do you think about your new year? What are you going to do?
I told you, dude. I'm going to fucking...
You got to get to 200 and grow your hair to your butt?
200, grow my hair to my butt. Get really... Just start working with like clubs and fucking cudgels. I'm trying to pick
What's
my
medieval... cudgel?
This is like a short, fat club. Like it's fat on the one end.
Oh.
I might just work with like, you know, some like short, curvy swords, some daggers.
Yeah.
Some dagger work.
Yeah, your daggers.
I don't have a New Year's resolution.
Daggers?
Huh?
You got to work on throwing knives.
I might work on my poison game.
You do need better potions.
Yeah, I might get some some potions.
You got to get potions, dude.
My cousin used to make potions for his neighbor.
Really?
He used to make like poison potions. He'd put like those red berries from holly trees and mash them in the water to get this girl to drink. He would try to get her to drink them. She'd be like, no, I'm not drinking them. She's like, I hate her so much.
You're trying to poison her with berries.
Yeah. With like elderberries. You put like dirt and red berries into like a plastic water bottle and like shake it up and be like, drink this. She'd be like, I'm not drinking it. Like, come on, drink it. You're like, actively trying to poison
her.
You're trying to poison her, dude. It was so, I would just sit there and watch and be like, fuck, he's going to poison this girl. I would have let it happen.
Yeah, you need to work on your potions this year.
Mm-hmm.
Throwing knives.
Yep.
You need to grow your hair down to your ass, which that's going to be tough.
Yeah.
You might be middle of the back.
Yeah, I mean, it'll probably just stop.
You think? I bet you can grow it long, dude.
It's going there. I'm just becoming like a weird fucking like whale man.
What have you been becoming, dude?
There's a guy
who, like an R that.
There's a guy who used to come to my grade school and talk about whales, and he had a long ponytail, and every day I'm kind of like, I'll probably just become the whale man, like talk about whales at the grade school.
That's a fucking sick gig.
Yeah, I know.
All your prospects are sick.
I know, whale man.
Jet skis. Whale
jet ski
man,
tour guide,
Ren Faire. You could actually probably do all three.
I think more so though. I want to go more towards the just get into the Game of Thrones. Just put my time in at the Ren Faire.
Yeah,
just work on my British accent. Like, hello.
Get into the dark arts. Also, you need to fucking work on the potions.
I know. But no, that's my resolution. I don't really have one. I was fucking killing it before the end of the year.
Yeah.
So why would I change it up?
That's nice.
Why would I change it up?
I got to make a few adjustments here.
Make a couple changes. I'm staying out of the VIP, basically.
I'm going to stop drinking.
Okay.
For the most part.
Yeah.
Now that it's January, I think I can get a couple solid weeks in.
Yeah.
I was doing all right before Christmas.
Christmas hurt. I'm still hungover.
I got drunk. Yeah. Too much. And then if I don't booze for a couple months, that'll be good.
Yeah, you'll feel good.
I'll just booze occasionally.
You'll feel good.
And I got to drop some LBs.
What are you trying to get down to? 170?
170, yeah.
You should get down to 170.
I should drop 70.
You should just go full-on machinist, dude, and drop like 40 pounds.
If I was 170, that means I would lose like 80 pounds.
Don't do that. What are you trying to get to?
I don't know. Just whatever.
200?
Just take it steady. No, not 200. That's just unattainable. I'm like 255 right now.
250?
I'm like 260 probably.
Damn, dude, that's sick.
Yeah.
I'm trying to get up there.
6'3", 260, dude.
That's awesome.
Come find out.
That's awesome.
And yeah, that scale I bought is just inaccurate.
Yeah, that's a heavy scale.
Well, that was like an $8 scale.
That's good. That's like when Arnold used to wear cut sleeve shirts to the gym when his belly would stick out. That thing adds about 10 pounds.
It does. Every time I get on, I'm like, what the fuck?
What the fuck am I doing?
No, I was thinking I was going to go the Bill Burr route, which is like just 3 pounds, 2 pounds a week.
Yeah.
Weigh yourself at the beginning and the end of each week. See what you got.
What is he, like skinny fat or something? He's always talking about losing weight, but he doesn't look that fat.
Well, he boozes a lot, and then he gets bloated.
Yeah.
He fluctuates around like what you are.
Yeah, the Irish face can definitely bloat quick, dude.
Yeah.
That's just totally booze activated.
Yeah. If I stop boozing for a little, and it's corny for your resolution to be to lose weight.
No, it's not.
I think I'm going to go with it. And yeah, then, you should. I'm not going to stop dip.
you resolve not to?
I resolve not to.
That's a resolution.
My resolution is to continue to chew tobacco.
Yeah, I mean, that's part of your weight loss goals.
It actually is part of my weight loss goal. Like, if I'm hanging out here and they, like, order wings or pizza or something, the only way I'm not munching
dip.
Five slices is
start,
if I toss
You should start dip. Taking, like, Rip Fuel.
No.
Those, like, Xenadrine fat burners, dude.
I need you to conjure up a potion, dude.
That's true.
Get me a potion.
I'll go to the gas station and get you some fucking fat blockers, dude.
No.
gas station. I took them to get ripped one time, and I ended up just totally breaking out and like having to lay by a ceiling fan naked. There's stuff they make. They basically put you in a fever.
Really?
So they raise your body temperature by like a degree or two, so you just burn fat. But it's just very unhealthy, as you can imagine, to be in a feverish state.
It'd be terrible.
So I took one and just got real hot and blotchy and got naked and laid by a fan and was like, oh.
Oh, man.
Thought I was getting ripped, dude.
Oh, yeah, and yoga. I'm going to do yoga.
That's a good resolution.
I got a new yoga mat.
That's a good resolution.
Just going to do yoga up here in the living room.
Nice.
And then continue to ball the fuck out, dude.
That's sick. Yeah, I'm just going to keep going at it, dude.
You going to come back to the game soon?
Stand up?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Take a little hiatus.
I took a real sick hiatus. I always go to the hills, dude. I'm like Luke Skywalker.
True.
I go to the hills for a while and I fucking observe.
I'll find you. I'll
come find me,
you
dude. Out,
hand you a mic.
Yeah.
Be like, we need you.
I got to get down there.
I am the only one fighting on our side right now, dude.
What is it? Just pure
me
fucking...
versus gay bullshit every
really?
Day. I have a lightsaber just...
Is that all it is right now in stand-up?
No. I mean, stand-up's always fucking gay.
Yeah, but still.
Stand-up sucks.
Yeah.
Stand-up, dude. Even I did that theater show. I was just sitting backstage like, oh, God.
Yeah.
I didn't want to go out there.
Yeah, that's my thing, too. I the last couple of shows I did, I would just look at people's faces and that look of, like, looking at me like, come on. I look at them like, fuck you.
Yeah.
No, I would get so mad. The last show I did, I think, was the show we did in, like, the rain. Remember that? And, like,
oh, wow. No way.
No, I must have done one after that.
You did. The last show you did was, I remember, it was the mic.
Oh, yeah, that was a helium mic, yeah.
Yeah.
But that show, I remember sitting there, and there was just, like, dudes in fedoras just, like, judging me.
You
and
got,
I was like,
you got off
fuck
stage,
this.
And you're like, fuck that shit. And I was like, oh, wow.
Oh, I hated it.
He's actually mad.
I was just like, I sat there, like, it was raining. I'm like, this is so, I was mad that they didn't cancel it.
Yeah.
It's fucking pouring rain. We're in a backyard. Just cancel this shit.
No, I meant the helium.
Oh, bike. Yeah. I was mad because I sat there all night. And then what pisses me off when there's a decent crowd,
yeah.
And you go on at the end, and there's no one left. And it's just
that does suck.
Fucking damn it.
Yeah, I
might make a return.
Because I was
going
after you, and you came off, and you're like, fuck that shit.
I was so mad.
Because didn't, like, the mic, I remember the mic fell out. That's what it was.
The mic fell out.
Up.
But it was, I was like, whatever, and I was talking, and it was just like, people were chatting the whole time, and I was like, this is a fuck, I'm sitting here for three hours.
You weren't wrong.
Yeah, it pissed me off.
Yeah.
I don't like a night bird schedule.
Because I was expecting you to come off and be like, oh, that sucks, and like to laugh. But you came off and you're like, fucking bullshit. And I was like, oh, fuck.
I hated it, dude. I hate staying up late anymore.
Yeah,
I like going depressing. To bed early. I like getting up early. It's the best. And then like I was out late. I'm sitting for 3 hours. And I go up and it's just people like, maybe you should try to be. But it's just like, fuck these guys.
Yeah.
Fuck these guys.
I was on stage at McGoobie's on Saturday. And this guy was like, I was like, what are you guys getting weird about? Because if I talk about race there, it's fun to make fun of Baltimore for race.
Yeah.
It's like, you guys get a little nutty if we're talking about race. And they're all like, there's just this dork. He was like, why don't you talk about pets? Just screamed that out. And I was like, you want me to talk about pets? He was like, yeah, everybody loves pets. Ugh. I was like, I just told a story about how I can't jerk off unless a dog's crying now.
Yeah.
He was like, oh. I was like, you happy you said pets, you fucking weirdo?
You just told that story or you just did it?
Yeah, well, he was like, do you want to talk about pets? And I was like, oh, I got a pet story.
Oh, you hit him with that one.
I was like, my girlfriend and I just got a dog.
Yeah.
And now I got to lock up a puppy every time I want to jerk off. And the guy was like, oh.
He was not what he was expecting.
Yeah.
That was one that met a lot of resistance when I kept talking about, I was hell-bent on making dog abuse funny for a while, and no one was getting on board with it. When I was talking about rescue dogs and how, like, they're just shitty and how, like,
yeah,
you should just let them outside and let them fucking, like, instead of putting them down, just let them run around and get hit by a car. And people were just, like, not on board with that.
No, they're not going to let that.
Not on board.
Dude, I'm excited for your return.
It would be sick.
You're going to be weird as fuck.
I'll be so weird.
That'll be better.
Anything I've thought of to do for stand-up, I'm like, that's just me being weird on stage.
Yeah, that's what you started to do at the end, and it was good.
Yeah, yeah.
You started to just be talk about being a fucking whale man.
Yeah.
That was funny as fuck.
But yeah, we'll see. I want to do stand-up at lunchtime.
No, you don't.
If I could do it at like noon, I'd be all over it.
Oh, you mean just for your life, for the schedule?
Yeah.
I bet you could get it to where at least at Helium you go up early.
Yeah.
And you can just leave.
We'll see. I'll see if I get the itch again.
Get back, dude.
I should.
I need you back.
I know. That's the thing.
Get it back.
I hate idling around. Stand up half of it is just sitting there, twiddling your fucking thumbs.
I started going to Helium late as fuck.
Yeah, that's a good move.
Yeah.
But
like I get there like 3 or 4 before me.
That's a good move.
Yeah. And at Mike's, it's kind of the point where I can just show up.
Yeah, maybe next week I'll pop in, try to get on early.
It's
just swag out.
The mic's tomorrow.
They're doing it tomorrow?
Yeah.
Why are they doing that?
I don't know.
I might.
Well, anyway.
I'm going to roll up and bomb.
The listener right now is like,
come check me out, dude. I know.
Oh, fuck. I should.
Yeah, we're at an hour anyway.
We're at an hour. Good. Let's get the fuck out of here. Listener, I hope your new year sucks. I hope you accomplish nothing.
365 nofap. Let's go, boys.
You're going nofap?
All year.
That's impossible.
Forever, dude.
Dude, shut up.
Forever.
Shut up.
I mean, I'll be honest. If I fall, I'll let you know. Today was like, last night and today was, I was in the throes of a fever. All I could do was fap myself into oblivion, dude, and I didn't do it.
Really?
Dude, yeah. All I could do was, if I fapped, I would have passed out. I had a loaded rig right in front of me, dude, and I didn't use it.
The last cast, when you brought up nofap, and I was like, oh shit, I haven't jerked off in like 3 days. Mm-hmm. I forgot. I jerked off that night.
You let out a screecher?
Yeah, but it's just, I was like, oh, nice.
So when you don't jerk off for 3 days, you don't notice a big difference?
No.
What?
I mean, maybe it's happening and I don't associate it with not jerking off. Maybe I'm just like, oh, I feel good.
Like right now, I got about 5 or 6 days in me. If I were to let this out, it would be full, just like, just hard fucking chucks, dude.
This Friday and Saturday, you can see me at the Mohegan Sun in the Poconos. Shit. And then the 7th, oh, never mind. 12th and 13th. Philadelphia and Lancaster. That's who the fuck that is.
Oh, fucking
yeah, I have his name in there.
Boy, yeah.
Marty. Yeah, I have his name in my phone. I was like, who the fuck is Marty? And then 18th, 19th, 20th at Helium Comedy Club.
Nice.
So, suck our dicks.
Come get some.
You really, how long do you think you're going to go with a nofap?
Fucking forever, dude.
Why?
I don't like doing it.
You don't like jerking off?
No, I don't. It's a bad habit. It forms into an instant bad habit for me.
No. Oh, all right.
If it was smoking cigarettes, I'd be like a 4-pack-a-day cigarette smoker. To where I'd be like, yeah, just you shouldn't do that.
Really?
Yeah. Dude, I love jerking off. Cumming's my favorite thing in the world.
I mean, cumming's cool.
No, it's not cool, dude. It's the best. It's literally the best.
It is the best.
It's the best.
I don't know. I don't have that.
It's all I care about.
If I jerk off, it's just like, all right.
That's my favorite.
Why don't you just jerk off?
I can't, because then it'd start jerking off too much.
How much?
All the time.
Just once a day is fine.
Dude, you don't understand. Then enters the porn. Then it goes down the weird porn rabbit holes.
You're allowed to look at weird porn.
No, you're not.
It's America, dude.
It's coming out. Everyone's shit's going to get released.
Who cares? If everyone's gets released, who cares? Yeah. You can't be the only guy jerking off to trannies.
Still.
I mean, you've released it on the podcast.
Still.
Before you preemptively.
I'm talking about my heirs, dude.
With your
like
boys?
All of your kids will be able to look at your. By then they'll be like that'll be they don't give a fuck. All of our sons will be gay.
You think?
Yeah. Not mine, but mine will be the last, dude. The last red blooded man. What's that? Oh, don't show me porn, dude. It's fucked up.
You don't want to see porn?
I don't want to see that. I'm immune to that.
What'd that do to you?
That's I'm immune to that. That's too that vanilla. That's too vanilla for me.
Really?
It's like Splenda.
Well, that was I didn't show you. I didn't want to show you.
That was a girl on top. Yeah.
I didn't want to.
The noises will fuck me up. Yeah, I hit the noises. Say,
yeah. I know you're a sound hound.
I'm out of here, dude. Before you hit me with those noises, send
I won't
me
do
into
that
oblivion.
Too, I promise.
No, I'd be fine.
Yeah.
I'd be fine.
You'd be able to nofap.
I can nofap those noises.
I mean, you're fucking.
Huh?
You're still nutting.
Yeah. About once a week or so.
Once a week.
So I hold it up and I fucking just.
You got to up that to twice.
I do. It's tough with the work schedule.
I know. I understand.
But yeah, I'm
once a week's hard to come by.
And it's also, you know, I've learned from my previous relationship not to be a pussy brat. I was a big time pussy brat.
Yeah, you were demanding.
I guess it would be demanding, but I would definitely be. I was really like if I didn't have sex whenever I wanted to, I'd just be like, and be so.
It's really hard not to.
I know.
If you want to have sex and your girlfriend doesn't. It really sucks.
Well, it's also tough, too, if you, like, go out for, like, an expensive dinner. And afterwards, you're like, well, this dinner was such, it sucked. I spent so much money. I'm definitely going to have sex now. And it's just like, good night. And you're like, what the fuck was that all for?
Oh, see, I never have done that.
Dude, it sucks.
If it was a date, maybe. But, like, in a relationship?
Yeah, but it's like, at least give me a fucking hand job, man. Like, come in. We just went out. I spent fucking $150. I'm not going to get a handy, man.
You're not wrong. You're exactly right. That should handy? Be. That should be the case.
Yeah, but I was a big time pussy brat to where I'd be like,
yeah. If I try to have sex with my girlfriend and she doesn't want to, I'm just fully fucking like,
dude. I've from the inception of this relationship, I've been too cool for school and the pussy the whole time, and I swear to God, it's the only way to do it.
Yeah, definitely.
Like, if you don't, I don't really feel like it tonight. I'm like, don't even sweat it. In my head, I'm like. As soon as you show that hand, you're
in
fine.
In your head, you're the guy from Black Mirror. They're like, exit game. Just stuck in a vacuum of nothingness. Just like, exit this. Yeah. I had to fucking exit game last night.
Took off.
I had my fucking,
you ran away.
I had my hand chirping in my ear while
you
I was watching
away?
The Sugar Bowl. And I was just like, I'm going to my parents to watch this.
Take damn. It easy.
Yeah.
They don't like that at all.
It was a solid move, in my opinion.
I mean, I know.
It was mid-fight, and I was just like, listen, I don't give a fuck. I'm going to watch this game.
I do the walk, dude. I do
yeah,
the
you
walk.
Said that
I
last
do the
time.
Bruce
Take
Springsteen,
a walk.
Bruce
That's
Springsteen
what I did.
Walk. Yeah,
took a walk.
I walk around. I'm like streets of Philadelphia. Fucking just listen to headphones.
All right. You've had enough, listener.
Yeah,
I'll admit this wasn't our most outrageous thing.
I have a fucking fever, dude.
Matt's sick and
sick. Giving you something.
Yeah, I enjoyed it.
Watch Black Mirror.
We're gonna try to get some shirts made.
Yeah,
we do have to do that.
Yep.
We got those sick fucking designs.
Yep.
Get a nice shirt for you.
Thinking a nice guest. We'll get a hot guest next week.
Oh, yeah. Next week we'll have a good guest. And yeah, I hope you had a happy new year and get ready to have the best year of your life.
2018 is going to change everything.
What do you think is going to happen to the Secret Podcast this year?
Takes off.
You think it takes off or we never, if we don't? It just goes two ways here.
I mean, it's either going to take off or just enter the catacombs of the internet.
Yeah.
It's going to just enter like the MySpace.
If I get one fucking thing, this thing gets deleted.
Yeah.
Instantly.
This is fucking.
This is kryptonite.
I mean, this is the Hillary emails, dude.
This is the Hillary emails. Ah, we shouldn't be saying this.
Why?
These dorks will save this.
Can they? Yeah, they probably
dildos
can.
Dildos will download it.
Whatever. Fuck them.
Yeah.
Peace out.
Blackmail. Maybe a future career of mine. Download this.
Yeah.
If you want to ruin Nat's book.
Yeah.
Download this.
He's sick. I love him.
All right. God bless.
Later. Praise the Lord. I was born to travel. Feeling like.
mic slash in front of the chapel. I'm lean back with the Les Paul. Shit I smoke is like cholesterol. Spill dressing on the vest at the festival, the best of all. Had a midget Puerto Rican at my beck and call. Best believe that there was neck involved. Fuck around and almost wrecked the sub. We took acid for 10 days straight up in the mountains. Started running.